Hi and welcome back. Today I have a product review for you, or kind of a first impression on the Gemini electronic die cutting machine. It's a machine that I have been wanting to try out for a long time and I finally got my hands into it. Since I am a professional crafter, I do lots and lots of die cutting and my hand already hurts, so I thought it would be a good transition. So today I'm going to do the unboxing and show you how it works. I will also point out the pros and cons of using such a machine, and maybe this video is going to be helpful for you to decide if this is a machine for you or not. First, let's take a look on what you get on the box. So here are the two cutting plates. These are quite big. They are 9 by 12.5, which means that they fit both letter size as well as A4 European size. So you have there a big platform, which means that you can die cut many dies with one passing. This is the magnetic shim. Again, it is the exact same size as the cutting plates. In previous versions, it used to be black. Now it comes with a grid on both sides. And it also gives you lots of measurements on popular sizes, which I find really convenient. Now, the fun part about this magnetic plate is that you can place your dies on top and they are going to stay put. They are not going to move on you. You can see here how nicely it grabs the dies and it's easy to remove them. Now, I'm going to keep the labels on top of all those different seams that I pick out of the box so you can see them all together on the right side of my screen. Now, the milky one is the plastic shim, which is really important for making the sandwiches to cut out your thin dies, and I will be using all of them and show you the sandwiches later on. This is the metal cutting plate. This is really important when you are trying to cut out very intricate dies. Usually, when you buy a die cutting machine, you need to get those metal shims separately. However, with this machine, you get everything you need all together in one box. So this is the embossing mat. It's rubber and very flexible, and it is used when you want to emboss with the dies. There are some dies that do cut out as well as embossing. So all together you get 6 different plates to create different sandwiches depending on what you want to do in the machine. 2 cutting plates, your plastic shim, your magnetic shim, the metal cutting plate and the rubber embossing mat. Now, with the 2 cutting plates, you will need replacements at some point since they get warped and get lots of markings from die cutting. However, with the rest of the shims, you will not need to replace them as long as you are careful and you don't die cut them by mistake. There is also a handy little leaflet that you want to keep. I'm not a big fan of user manuals, but this is really helpful. It has just the illustrations that you need for different sandwiches you want to do for embossing and die cutting. And although this leaflet looks big and complicated, trust me, the rest of the pages are on different languages, so all the info that you need is just in 4 pages. Now, in the box, you will also get some toys for you to play and put your machine into use right away, especially if you are new to die cutting and you don't have any dies or embossing folders in your stash yet. This is a 3D embossing folder. I'm going to take it out of the package so you can see the design. It is called Ornate Lace and I will be using it in this video later on so you can see how it embosses and creates a beautiful design, really three-dimensional. Now you will also get 4 different die sets and that includes different butterflies, hexagons, and look at those floral frames and the floral borders. I absolutely love how intricate those are, so we can put the machine into test later on. So I'm going to put those aside. And of course, in the box, you will get the cable. I got 2 cables inside my machine. It has the European version, which I'm going to use, but there is also the UK version inside as well. So depending on which part of the world you are, make sure to order the correct one. Now I'm going to put everything aside, clean up my entire area and bring in the machine. So here it is out of the box. I just love that it is white, love the clean and simple look on it. It has 3 buttons on the top and the logo. And here is the slot where you fit your sandwiches. Now the machine is no joke, it's really heavy. That's about 7 kilos of weight or about 15 pounds. There are handles on each side that you can use if you want to move the machine around. But let's be honest here, I wouldn't recommend to use this on the go if you're going to crops and stuff. This is a machine that you need to have on your desktop and it's not going to move from there. On top of your Gemini, you will get three buttons. One is the turn on and off. There is the pause one and the third one is the reverse, which I find really handy. Especially if you want to run your dies a couple of times to make sure that everything is cut out perfectly. And it also brings the blades right in front of you again, so it's really convenient. Now I plugged in my machine and let's see how it works. Now the main power switch is located at the back. Turn it on and just leave it as it is, and then I will use the front button to turn my machine on and off again. So this is the turn on and you can see how it lights up all the buttons. Now I know that my machine is ready to use. And now let's play a little bit. This is the first time I'm going to try this machine and make a sandwich. So I decided to start with the easiest one, which is using the embossing folder. I'm going to put the machine on the side so you can see it. And I'm not speeding up the video at all. You will be able to see how long it takes for the whole plate to go through the machine and back. And also, I'm leaving the sound on so you can see how noisy it is. And again, this is an honest review. And at the end, I will sum up the pros and cons to help you decide if you want to get it. Now, I'm going to create my sandwich there, just placing a piece of cardstock inside the folder. And then all I have to do is to use the two clear cutting plates. I'm going to fit those through the machine and it grabs them automatically. You can probably hear some sounds, which are completely normal. And here comes my plate on the other side. And I absolutely love the fact that I don't have to use a handle. This is the number one selling point for me when it comes to Gemini. And check this out. I was so amazed when I saw that. This is absolutely amazing. Look at the depth of this embossed paper. Absolutely stunning. I kept looking at it front and back. I couldn't believe how amazing and dimensional this is. So in any case, to conclude, for doing embossing with embossing folders, the sandwich is super easy and you can see the results. Just use the two cutting plates, top and bottom. Now I'm going to move on and do some die cutting. I will use the clear cutting plate, then the milky plastic shim, and then on top the magnetic shim. So now I have three different plates, one on top of the other. Okay, I'm going to place them down and I'm going to bring in some of the dies that were included in the box. I will try and use some that are quite open space and easy to cut out, such as those hexagons. But I'm also going to bring in a very intricate butterfly, as well as a few flowers and some foliage, just to see how the machine is going to perform. Again, I'm moving slowly. I'm not speeding up the process at all, as you see the video. And I'm leaving all the sounds on so you can have the real experience. So this is where I had the feeling that this is going to cut out the hexagons, but the rest of the dies, since they are quite intricate, they would need to use the metal shim. However, I'm going to give it a try and see how this is going to work. I'm going to fit the sandwich. And you can hear all the cracks. Now I'm going to pause it and rewind, so it's going to bring the blade on my side again. Plus, this way I give it another chance for cutting those intricate dies, and we will see together what's the result. Of course, it cut out the hexagons beautifully. I was expecting that. And now this is a completely new plate and you can see that I get indentations and do not get mad about this or frustrated. This is something that happens with every cutting plate. It also has warped a little bit, which means that on the next cut I'm going to place it in a different direction, and I'm going to show it to you later on. So just don't get frustrated by getting all those marks on your cutting plates. Now you can see that I cut out this thick cardstock beautifully, and what really surprised me is that the rest of the dies did cut out beautifully those intricate designs. And to tell you the truth, I wasn't expecting that. However, I did give the machine a chance and ran it through twice. I don't know if it was going to cut out the butterflies and the rest with one passing. The fun part is that I avoided using the metal shim, which is fine by me. So I'm going to give it one more go. This time I will use one of the most intricate designs that were included in this box. This time again I'm going to try it out and cut it without using the metal shim, which is intended for intricate designs. I just want to give it a go and see what happens. So I'm going to remove all these dies. I'm going to place on top the most intricate that I found. And again, I'm using the same sandwich. So underneath my die, there are three shims: the clear cutting plate, the milky plastic shim, and the magnetic shim. Then the die, blade side up, the paper on top, and look how I used my plate previously. Now I'm going to flip it. This way it's going to help the warping and it's going to keep my plate in a good condition. Every time you use it, just make sure that you pass it through in a different direction. And I'm going to run it through my Gemini. So I run that just once and let's see what happens. And I have the feeling that this cut out beautifully, and that's the truth. All I have to do is to just pop out all those little bits and pieces with my pick tool. So to tell you the truth, this was a huge surprise, since it does cut out with the normal sandwich without even using the metal shim. However, I guess that if you have lots and lots of dies loaded on your plate, then you probably need to use that shim. But always give it a try without it before going ahead and using the metal shim. This is going to help your cutting plates stay in a good condition for a longer time, since you don't add too much pressure on them. Now to conclude, this is the perfect die cutting machine for me, especially because it is electronic and it doesn't have a handle. So if your arm hurts from die cutting, or if you have a special health condition that doesn't allow you to turn it, then this is a machine for you. I also love the fact that it has a big platform that fits an A4 or a letter size, which means that you can do lots of die cutting with one passing. Another plus is that it cuts like a dream, and you saw the demo here today. But even if something doesn't cut out, then you have all the shims that you need included in the box, so you don't have to buy any extras to make different sandwiches. And also it includes a magnetic shim, so the dies are not going to move on you. Now, things to consider before you buy this machine. Keep in mind that this is a heavy machine. It's about 7 kilos, 15 pounds, so it is not portable. Then again, it is quite noisy, and you were able to hear the cracking and the sound that it does. It's not that noisy, but still there is some noise. You will also need to replace the cutting plates at some point, but that's probably a disadvantage of all die cutting machines out there, whether they are electronic or not. And finally, you cannot run through your big C6 dies. You can run through any other wafer thin die that you have, but not the big ones. Now the Gemini that you saw me use today is the original one, so the 9x12.5 plate size, but there are two more versions, the Gemini Junior, which is a 6x9, and the Gemini Go, which is 3x6, and it is portable because it's very small and it is lightweight. Feel free to pause your screen here so you can see all the stats. Depending on your needs, you can go smaller, which means that you save on cost. The machine is not as heavy, but you get a smaller cutting plate. I hope this video was helpful and informative. If you have any questions, let me know down below. And if you like my product reviews, let me know which other product you would like me to review. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.